balls the size of cantaloupes. And just because you have nothing, don't go hard on Vegan Gains, because he's putting it out there. He's working hard and getting the name out there, getting the vegan cause out there. So all you fucktards on fucking YouTube, get your hand off it and start doing some content. Do you even fucking YouTube, bro? Do you even YouTube, brah? You fucking don't, so shut the fuck up. Until you're at that level, you can't say shit. Fuck off. Don't get in the way of people actually doing shit in life. So these guys found vegan lifestyle through Vegan Gains, just as many of these young guys are. And just out of curiosity and digging deeper, I am still not sure about the whole humans are supposed to consume meat argument. Nonetheless, I have stopped consuming all animal products and bought myself a huge box of bananas. You're going to need more than one box, bro. You're going to need a fucking warehouse. And this is good because Sydney's a good place for fruit lovers. Flemington Markets. Flemington Markets. I would like to know if there's some bikes out there that can support my weight and that you can recommend. At your weight, 200 kilos, your local bike shop can help you. I'd probably recommend a 29er mountain bike with some disc brakes. Go to the local shop, maybe a giant, just anything with 29-inch wheels will be a good start. Mountain bike from your local shop that can fit you up. He lives in the suburbs, is on a budget. Mate, so was I. I was living on the street. I was living on the street, but I still had a fucking S-Works mountain bike because that's what I wanted to do. I literally would camp out, man. I was homeless. I'd ride my fucking S-Works mountain bike around, camping in the bushes, because all I cared about was money. All I cared about was having enough money to have my fruit and my bike. I didn't give a fuck about accommodation, so I would have a sleeping bag and I'd camp on the beaches or at Morialta. Actually, one time I was so poor that I flew from Cairns to Adelaide. Instead of going to Adelaide, I didn't have the extra $50, so I had to fly into Melbourne. So the same $50, I rode from Melbourne to Adelaide in 48 and a half hours. That's how broke I was at one point. But again, this is poverty in Australia. It's not like poverty, because half the world lives on less than $2 a day. So when I share my stories about, yeah, it's really tough, and it's fucking nothing, man. I still had a bicycle. I still had food to fucking eat. These people in certain parts of the world, they don't even hardly have any fucking any food. So we're doing it fucking easy. I'm fucking G'd up this morning. I'm fucking G'd up. I did a 200k ride the other night, and I went to bed like 8 o'clock last night, and I am fucking pumped. Quick, got a question here. I'd like to know your opinion on amphetamines in aid of countering obesity. What happens is a lot of doctors recommend their patients get on amphetamines. People are like, oh my God, amphetamines, that's like those guys sell on the street. No, here's the thing I never really knew. When I was doing amphetamines in the rave scene back in the 90s, we would buy speed amphetamines off dealers. Why the fuck did we do that? We just could have gone to the local family doctor and gotten them. So it's like the local family doctor is your number one stop for any stimulant or any anabolic steroid. So don't buy steroids in the gym rat, the TMW dude or whatever. Buy them from your local family doctor. If you're going to do speed and drugs, don't buy them from the fucking street dude. Buy them from your local family doctor and pharmacist. They can help you out. Get off your nut and get swole. I would not recommend it because you got to change your diet, bro. You're not 200 kilos because you're deficient in amphetamines. You're 200 kilos because you've been eating the standard Aussie diet. And I'd be 200 kilos as well. I literally would be 200 kilos or more because I love food so fucking much. How many people on the planet do you know who eat as much as me? There's not many. There's not many, is there? And the people who do eat as much as me and need a standard Aussie diet, they're fucking obese. So when I sit down to eat and eat that much volume, and people eating that from the standard Aussie diet, they're obese, and I'm lean. And people who follow our advice are lean as well, long term. Since cutting out all animal products, I have become the best in me in terms of actually wanting to do exercise. And because when you're carved up, you want to get out there and go. You need carbohydrates. And also, he says, I remember the amount of dedication I put into calorie restricting. Maybe that's why I ballooned as drastic as I did. Nonetheless, I'm committed to my health. So this is fantastic. We have another example of restriction. Calorie restriction never works. You will balloon. But I think this guy's, or I know this guy's, he's reached a point, and now he's going to fucking shred right down to 60, 65 kilo in due time. Maybe 50 kilos, we'll see, but at least 60, 65 would be a healthy BMI. He's going to feel a lot better. And he says, cheers, cunt, stress kidney Sydney resident. And this is the demographic we're trying to appeal to, is the young crew coming up, man. Because most people over 50 or 30, they don't really give a fuck. They're too caught up in mortgage, kids, family, work shit. They don't want to change shit. But when you're a teenager, you're a bit more like, I can got room for change. Let's go to the local doctor and see what we can get from the local doctor. All right, let's see what we've got here. Now, I don't pretend to be a doctor, except when your mum comes to my place on Wednesday night. Let's see what we've got here. The common weight loss drugs that you can get from your local family doctor. Now I've got all these from my local family doctor, local friendly pharmacy. And these are all drugs that you commonly use in weight loss scenes. We've got asthma puffers, salbutamol, increases fat burning effect. This is a steroid that I started when I was 8 years old, 7 years old maybe. And I was on this for how many years in my life? A long, 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 long time. This is one of the most common weight loss drugs out there, and it's really bad for your fucking teeth. So we've got the salbutamol, Benzolin, banned in cycling. You need to fucking jump through hoops to be able to use this in cycling. This is a performance enhancing drug. And I see people in fucking running races, 8 year olds. So I use this as a sports day, man. I'm about 8 years old having like 10 puffs for sports day. I was doping as an 8 year old. If someone like Chris Froome or something uses this, they need to jump through loopholes to get past to use it legally. If you're 8 year old kid on sports day, no worries, mate. We have primotestin, testosterone enanthate. Powerful anabolic steroid, burns fat, builds muscle, increases red blood cell count, weight loss drug. We have phentermine. Remember these phentermine pills I had from last year? That is for like almost 2 years in my drawer. Phentermine is the most common drug that if you're obese, the doctors will put you on. It's like an amphetamine-based thing. 30 milligrams phentermine, I call it metamine or duramine. Very popular with the BBG girls or Ashley Bynes, things like that. But I don't recommend it because all it's doing is going to fuck your adrenals, fuck your fire later on. And you're going to balloon out. Look at Ashley Bynes. Ballooning out. Look at all the celebrities, man. How many celebrities? I mean, do you have time for me to mention all the celebrities who balloon out after taking all these stimulants? It doesn't work long term. People, I'll do it short term, and then I'm like, no, no, no. It never fucking works long term. And in the short term, you're a fucking nut job to be around. So fuck off the drugs and do everything natty. We have Ritalin. I thought Ritalin would be really hard to get in Australia. Easy as fuck. Went to local doctor. What do you want, mate? How many milligrams? How many? Whatever. Just writing it out. What do you want? Yeah, did it. You know what, mate? Can't even pay attention. I'm too poor to pay attention. Have some Ritalin then. Ritalin. Now, this is a drug for kids. I love it. Can you read that there? I'll let you know what it says. Keep out of reach of children. Keep out of reach of kids until they can't pay attention and fucking fill them full of speed shit. Controlled drug. Possession without authority illegal. But we'll give it in the hands of 8-year-old kids at school. 5-year-old kids. What's the age of kids are taking Ritalin these days? It's fucking crazy. It's a fucking... I've taken that drug before. It's the same as speed, man. We're giving kids speed. We're giving kids speed. I couldn't believe how easy Ritalin was to get in Australia. Why the fuck in the 90s was I breaking in the cars and doing crime to buy speed, to have the money to buy speed from the local drug dealers when I could have just got some Ritalin or Adderall? I could have saved myself a lot of time, a lot of crime time, just getting drugs from the doctor instead. Sustenum 250, another testosterone ether mix. Testpropionate, phenylpropionate, isocaprate, and deconite. So we've got four types of testosterones here in little ester. Local family doctor, easy to get. Testosterone patches for, Tyler Hamilton, Lance Armstrong. Local family doctor, not a worry, mate. So drugs are easy to get. Don't do drugs from your gym rat friend. Don't do drugs from the street dealer. If you're going to do drugs, get them from the doctors. Get them from local family pharmacy. Get them from your local friendly family doctor. But I don't recommend doing drugs because you're not treating the cause. You're addressing the symptom. Drugs will tweak your metabolism. Yes, they work, but it won't be long term. What comes up must come down. So I would say change your diet, man. You're not 200 kilos because you're eating like us. And everyone knows that. It's pretty obvious. So that's my tip, man, is definitely you're on the right program now. And you don't need all the other shit. And I can this is the beauty, man. I can be honest and transparent and say I've done so many drugs in my life, both recreational, pharmaceutical, and everything works, but nothing works lasting long term than
Yeah, that's right.
If we lost
Yeah.
20 kilos. Yeah. Just in case we had any doubts.
No, we lost, we got pregnant. Oh, mate.
We did it. And the team doing it for Phil lost 20 kilos. 73 down to 53, 52, 50 sometimes. 23 kilos, depends on what you're talking about. Anyway, she lost the weight from binge eating.
It's not how much you eat, it's what you fucking eat that fucking matters. Now, me and Freely, we're clinical binge eaters, no doubt about it. We are clinical binge eaters. Example, Freely and myself, we'll have one of these each. This is 5 servings in here. It says 5 servings. This is for 5 people. At Freely and Dunata, we have 1 each. We don't share a bottle, we get a bottle each. Pasta, Freely will have a packet, I'll have a packet. 500 grams, 10 servings. On the back, 10 servings. All right, so we're up to 15 servings. 15 people could eat what we're eating. This pack has got 3 servings for a pack of lentils, a little can. And we haven't even had our daily calories yet. A bottle of juice, packet of pasta, a bit of lentils. Still haven't reached our calorie quota. Could have had 18 servings of food. 18 servings. So when someone says, I'm a binge eater, I had 5 bananas or 10 bananas or 40 dates. No. Look at how many fucking calories you're eating. Did you have 3,000 calories? Fucking awesome. Did you have 5,000 calories? Fucking awesome. Did you have 20,000 calories? Who the fuck can eat 200 bananas in a day? That would be fucking binge eating. But you physically couldn't fucking do it. Go to fucking Heart Attack Grill in Texas, you could do it. 2 of those 10,000 calorie burgers or whatever. So what I'm saying is that binge eating is bullshit. And that is a very pernicious belief to have. And Freely myself, pretty much the only one who's high profile on social media and fitness world who's gonna tell you otherwise. There's other been people who agree with us, but no one at our level who actually tell you how it fucking is. And that's because most people don't understand that. It's not about emotional eating or whatever. If you believe that, that is like, that's one of the most fucked things you can believe in your life. I don't say that out of aggression or whatever, I'm just saying that is a really fucked, limiting belief to have. That's like riding your bike up a mountain and go, man, if I ride too fast, I'm gonna like just melt the fucking road and like, the road's just gonna fucking swallow me up and I'm gonna die. It's fucking crazy. You need to fucking eat, you need to fucking breathe, you need to drink, you need to sleep. You need to go to the fucking toilet. So what I'm trying to say is that, Philly, do you wanna add anything in here?
No.
You want to? All right. See, I'm doing a good job here. Mm-hmm. All right. There we go. Freely agrees with me, man. So, girls, if you want to lose the weight, guys, if you want to get leaner, then listen to us. You can eat 2,000 calories a day, or you can have 3,000 calories a day and burn 1,000 calories from getting shit fucking done, doing some fucking exercise, walking the fucking dog. Look how skinny our dog is. Look at it. You know what I mean? Most people, dogs are fucking overweight, and they're sitting around going, "I want to munch." Walk your fucking dog. Walk your fucking kids. Get some shit done in life that you're not doing already, that you can be doing. Have some more calories and get some work done. Instead of cutting back calories, increase your fucking life output and eat more so you can do more. That's what we say. Eat more to do more. Simple as that. Post your comments and questions down below. Binge eating, we still binge eat. We fucking are clinically binge eating disorder people. And everyone says, you guys too skinny though. You binge eat, but you're too skinny. What's it gonna be? What's it gonna be? So imagine a world where we had our carbohydrate grams every day and we use those carbs to do fucking good to the planet. Good for the animals, good for humanity. Imagine if we ate more carbs with the intention of doing good on the fucking planet every day and getting fitter and leaner as a result of helping the fucking planet. Imagine. So instead of fucking eating less carbs, do more good. Eat more carbs, do more good. Simple as that.
It's okay. Good girl.
What are you doing next, baby?